In this video, I'm going to be comparing the Garmin Approach S20 Golf Watch to the Callaway GPS Y and also the Bushnell Neo Ion 2, and going to be talking about which one is worth picking up. So what we're going to be covering in this video are what the Callaway GPS Y does, the Bushnell Neo added features, and then the Garmin S20 added features. Also, which one's going to be best for you, and also the best place to pick them up. So I will just mention our gear giveaway. If you want to enter in, all you have to do is subscribe to the channel, like this video, comment giveaway down below. Do those three things and it'll be automatically entered. Okay, so let's start with the Callaway GPS Y watch. So this is an entry-level golf watch from Callaway. It's currently priced at around $140. It comes with over 30,000 worldwide courses, and it's going to show you the distance to the front, center, and back of the green. The watch is going to keep track of your score. It'll tell you your distance, so you know how far you hit each shot, and then it's going to record your greens and regulations and some other stats like that. So it is pretty cool. Who is this watch for? In our opinion, the GPS Y watch is fairly accurate, but it's not our favorite, and that's why we are not going to recommend it. The Garmin S20 is pretty much the same price, and it does have more courses, more features, and also a better battery life. Also, the band on the watch wasn't the most comfortable, and it actually started to break apart after about a year. So that's kind of why we aren't going to recommend this one. So let's jump over to the Garmin S20. So this is an entry-level golf watch, and it's currently priced at around $140. It comes loaded with over 40,000 worldwide courses, and it is going to show you the distance to the front, center, and back of the green, as well as hazards and doglegs. So it also has the auto shot feature, which is really cool. It's basically going to track your shots and then record them in the app, so you can go back after the round and see kind of where your common misses are, and it's going to give you a good idea on what part of your game needs work and kind of give you something to work on at the range. Who is the S20 for? So in our opinion, the S20 is one of the better watches for someone who's tighter on a budget. It's not the most advanced watch out there, but it is as accurate as any. The battery life is great, and it's going to show you most of the distance data you're looking for. If you're just getting started with golf, I would highly recommend a device like this, and the S20 is a perfect option because it's not going to break the bank either. Let's talk about the Bushnell Neo Ion 2. So this is a little bit of a more expensive golf watch from Bushnell, and it's currently priced at around $190. It comes loaded with over 36,000 courses from 36 different countries, and it's going to show you the distance to the front, middle, and back of the green. It's also going to allow you to input 4 different hazards for each hole. But this has to be done manually, which kind of sucks, just because no one was really going to want to, you know, spend the time putting in the manual distances. But who is this watch for? So in our opinion, the Ion 2 is a pretty decent golf watch, and it's quite a bit better than the Callaway that we talked about. It's got more courses, a better battery, and I found it to be a bit more comfortable compared to the Callaway. That being said, we do prefer the Garmin S20 over the Neo Ion 2, just because it is cheaper. It has a better app on it, and then it does have even more courses with an even better battery. So that's kind of our opinion of it. But let's just cover some pros and cons of these devices. So pros, they're fairly reasonably priced. They are just as accurate as any other golf watch, and then they really help you pick the right club and dial in your distance control. I know I always struggled before I got a GPS watch. I never really knew, you know, exactly how far I hit each club. I would always kind of guess. So I was generally either long or short. So just getting something like this really helped with distance control. Cons, I'm not the biggest fan of wearing watches while golfing. Some are, but I actually end up, I attach my watch to my bag instead of my wrist, and that works completely fine. You can't see a full hole overview on the watch, only the green shape. If you want to see a full hole overview, you can either use like your phone app that connects to the watch, or you can get a handheld GPS. But those are kind of the main pros and cons to these. So frequently asked questions, so are courses in my area on it? About 80% of the courses in my area were on it. They're always adding more as well. It's free updates and things like that, so they're always adding more courses. I found all of the full-size courses were on it. There was the odd par like 68 or, you know, par 70 that weren't, but generally most of them were. You can't actually phone them to see which ones for sure are on it, but like I said, pretty much any of the full size courses are going to be on it. Is there any activity tracking features? They come with basic activity tracking like steps, calories burned, sleep, that kind of thing. But are these devices worth it? Taking into account all the pros, all the cons. Overall, we would definitely recommend getting some sort of yardage finder, whether it's a watch, a handheld GPS, or a laser rangefinder, just because it's really helped improve my game and I think it can help you as well. These three options aren't the most advanced watches, but they do offer pretty much all the basic features you'd need. The Garmin S20 is our favorite on this list, and is probably our favorite budget golf watch, and we would give it a thumbs up for sure. But if you would like to see more images or reviews of any of the mentioned products, or you want to get any of them for the lowest price available, click the link in the description down below. At the time of the video, that was the best place I could find it, so you can go ahead and check out the current price if you want. And if you have any questions, leave a comment down below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And that's going to be it for the video. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you in the next one.